Welcome to this video, Coastal Plains of India. It is a subtopic of Indian relief features, Indian major relief features. It is a one of the subtopic prepared by me. K. Chiranjeevulu, ZP School, Muchuvalu. Srikalahasti Mandal, Chittoor district. By this end of this video, people will be able to understand the coastal plains of India, and they will also classify the coastal plains in India, there identify and locate the coastal plains in India map, and they understand the different names which are called in different states, and which state have the highest coastal plains, and how many states, such a details are understanding from this video. Let us welcome the first of all the definition. What is coastal? The coast, also known as the coastal line or seashore, is defined as the area where land meets the sea or ocean, or as a line that forms the boundary between the land and the ocean or a lake. That is the. Now let us come to the discussion about plains, coastal plains. We have both sides, western and eastern side coastal plains. This one is west coastal plain. It lies between the Western Ghats and Arabian Sea. This one, Western Ghats, Arabian Sea, this is West Coastal. It is lies between the Western Ghats and the Arabian Sea. This one, Eastern Coastal Plain, East Coast, it lies between Eastern Ghats and Bay of Bengal, between the Bay of Bengal, Eastern Coast, this one Eastern Coast, Eastern Ghats. The East Coast is lies between the Eastern Ghats and the Bay of Bengal. The coastal plains of India lies on either side of peninsular plateau along the western and eastern coast of India. They extend for about 6,150 kilometers from the Rann of Kutch, in the Gujarat state, to West Bengal in the eastern side, to West Bengal, the eastern side, through entire the Gujarat, from Gujarat towards the southwards, and towards the West Bengal. Now it runs over 9 states and 4 union territories, and its border is bound by the Arabian Sea on the west and Bay of Bengal in the east. The western coastal states are Gujarat, and Maharashtra, and Goa, and Karnataka, Kerala. These are the 5 states. In western coastal states, the ఈస్ట్ కోస్టల్ స్టేట్స్ తమిళనాడు ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ ఒరిస్సా అండ్ వెస్ట్ బెంగాల్ దీస్ ఆర్ ద ఫోర్ స్టేట్స్ ఇన్ ఈస్ట్ కోస్టల్ స్టేట్స్ with four union territories also lying on the coastal line are Diu, Daman, Pondicherry, Lakshadweep islands in the western side and Andaman Nicobar islands in the eastern side of Bay of Bengal. This is about a small information about Indian coastal lines. Let me discuss one by one state from the Gujarat. This is Ran of Kutch in Gujarat. Here onwards we have coastal plain in the western side. Gujarat is a state on the western coast of India with a coastal line of 1600 kilometers. It is the first highest coastal plain state in India. Then Konkan, also known as the Konkan coast, is a rougher section of the western coastal line of India, extends southwards all along the western side of the land area of Maharashtra and Goa. It meets the Kerala coast. This one, Kerala coast, is also known as Kerala coastal or Karnataka coast. Kerala or Karnataka coast. In Karnataka, it is called Kerala coast. Kerala coastal is a stretch of land alongside the Arabian Sea in the state of Karnataka. It's a very beautiful state. We have Mysore Palace and some more beautiful locations, historical places in Karnataka. The next one, in Kerala, the Malabar coast. In Kerala, we have the Malabar coast is a region of the southern west, southwestern seashore line of the mainland Indian subcontinent. Kerala states between the Western Ghats range and the Arabian Sea. The coast runs from South Goa to Kanyakumari on Indian Southern Trip of Kanyakumari. This one in Tamil Nadu, the Coromandel coast is the southeastern coast region of the India subcontinent, bounded by the Utkal Plains to the north, the Bay of Bengal to the east, the Kaveri Delta to the south, and the Eastern Ghats to the west of the Coromandel coast. Chennai Port, formerly known as Madras Port, is the second largest container port of India behind Mumbai's Navasena. The port is the largest one in the Bay of Bengal. The coastal line of Andhra Pradesh is located on the from Ichapuram of Srikakulam district to Tada of Nellore district, which geographically lies in between the coasts of Odisha and Tamil Nadu. This coastal stretch extends the waters of Bay of Bengal. It has the second largest coastal line with a length of 972 kilometers. Next to Gujarat, the coastal corridor consists of several ports, harbors, vast stretches of sand beaches, wildlife and bird sanctuaries, freshwater lake Kolleru, Pulikatsa, it's a salt lake. Utkal coast. It lies from Odisha to West Bengal. Kolkata port is one of the most important port. And in this region, we have mangroves, that is tidal forests. The important ports in India, in Gujarat, Kandla, in Maharashtra, Mumbai, JNPT, Goa, Panaji port, and Marmagava port, and in Karnataka, Mangalore port, in Kerala, Cochin, and in Tamil Nadu, Tuticorin, and Chennai. These are the two ports in Tamil Nadu. Visakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh, it's a natural port. Paradip in Odisha, Kolkata, and Haldia. These are the two in West Bengal. These are the important ports of we have in coastal plains, both sides of western and eastern sides. These are the states. We have totally 9 states, one Gujarat, in Maharashtra, Goa, and Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, and Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, and West Bengal. These are the 9 states we have coastal plains. Here, what is the difference between western coast and eastern coast? Western coasts are very slight one. Why? Because the elevation of the peninsular plateau is slight towards the east, tilt towards the east, so that's why the western coast is very slice, and it's a very slicely formed. Then here we have eastern coast. It's a broad area. Why? Because the total peninsular plateau is tilted towards the east, and Deccan plateau have rivers, that is Godavari and Krishna and Kaveri, Mahanadi. These are the rivers are formed the deltas. That's why the east coast is very broadly formed. So that's why it's a very broader area. It's a very fertile soils, delta region. It has water facilities and the plain areas. It's very useful to agriculture, agricultural products. So that is the difference between western coast, eastern coast. We have the total 9 states in the coastal plains. We have 3 sites of water, that is the Arabian Sea in western side, in southern side Indian Ocean, and in eastern side Bay of Bengal. The totally we have 9 states. I hope you are understanding well. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and share for more videos of social studies. Thank you for watching.